Konnichiwa.
We'd like to share an exercise that will be done at the upcoming course. The course is called The Guide to Breathing, and Vladimir will cover a variety of breathing types in Systema and show how they apply to survival.
Значит, мы когда встречаемся и изучаем страх, надо знать, то есть лучше знать два уровня.
It's always better to know two levels of breathing.
Первый уровень, когда мы пугаемся мозгом, то есть мы начинаем себе придумывать разные страхи.
The first one is when we're scared in our mind and even imaginary fears can happen.
Второй такой сложный уровень, когда наше тело начинает бояться каких-то воздействий физических, повода, страха или...
And the second one is when our body becomes scared or restricted.
Одно из самых простых упражнений, которое можно изучать, когда вы задерживаете дыхание и ждете психологического и физического воздействия на ваше тело.
There's one very helpful exercise. When you're standing with your back to the wall, hold your breath and prepare for psychological and physical threat.
Сейчас он будет держать дыхание, как только он начинает дышать, Али будет его бить, а я буду воздействовать психологически.
Robin now is holding his breath, and as soon as he resumes breathing, then our friend Ali will start hitting him physically, and Vladimir will start threatening him psychologically. And the goal for Robin is to maintain steady burst breathing, no matter what.
Yeah. When I punch it, for example, he used to see it, he would think about breathing more than in a...
You can see a very useful application of burst breathing or short breathing.
He needs to be strong enough to still, doesn't matter what, breathe. Inhale, exhale. That's the best way to make yourself stronger and use your breathing as a first level of to escape from fear, physically and psychologically.
Now Robin will hold his breath longer, more to the limit, and only when he cannot hold anymore, then he will resume breathing and the attacks will start happening. So it's best to hold your breath on partial exhale. So a little bit of air stays in the lungs, but not much.
When he's less afraid of my movement, that means he holds the air inside him properly. And what is good about this exercise, when I hit him, he creates some psychological, physical tension by holding air. But when we start to hit him, he starts to relax his body in a different way, of course, through the physical activity. But it's one of the best ways. After that, your body starts to feel better because it's remove that tension that appears when you hold your breath. And most of the time, we hold our breath anyway. Any contact, physical contact, we hold our breath. And you need to know how to, even when you hold your breath, you need to know how to restore yourself properly and heal even yourself.